cut to NASA.
The Trump administration's plan to cut funding at NASA is facing backlash, and also leading the charge today is one of the nation's most beloved science educators, Bill Nye, the science guy. He and more than 300 other science advocates rallied here on Capitol Hill to urge Congress, in their words, to save NASA. The White House plan would slash NASA's science funding by nearly half, a level that scientists warn could have tremendous consequences for space exploration, but also for U.S. economic growth and national security. Much of the agency's work is already halted, with the shutdown keeping some 15,000 NASA employees home and furloughed tonight. My source tonight is the aforementioned Bill Nye, CEO of the Planetary Society, the largest space advocacy organization in the world. And it is so great to have you back here on The Source. And also, you know, you're here fighting for this because you really believe that this would be detrimental if this goes through.
Oh, man. So if we cut NASA budget in half, science budget in half, that's pretty much ending it. It's pretty much done. When all these technicians, scientists, engineers have to get other jobs, you can't restart these things. Now, just economically, we have spent at least $23 billion over the last couple decades exploring Mars alone, let alone all these other, the outer planets. Everybody knows the expression black hole. Everybody knows Big Bang. That's from space exploration. Now, furthermore, the China National Space Administration is going to land people on the moon probably in the year 2030, 4.5 years. And it's going to be, for the older viewers, it's going to be another Sputnik moment where the United States eyebrows go up. Oh, my goodness, the other side has got some amazing space capability. And just mission for mission, if you go to the Planetary Society website, I have a chart I prepared earlier. If this were a cooking show, I'd say I prepared earlier. And just the green is what the Chinese National Space Administration is planning. The red and yellow is what the U.S. is planning to cancel. Now, everybody, the first Trump administration was all in to space. They were going, we're going back to Mars. We're going to do these things.
Space Force.
Yes. Well, Space Force, that job had to be done. Understand that the NASA is a civilian administration, but its relationship to the military, of course, is stronger and stronger. And for you students, the space shuttle bay, the cargo bay, was configured to handle military satellites. But all that aside, you don't want to cut NASA funding, and you don't want to cut NASA space in half. It will just end these programs, and this will lose our international competitiveness. And if we stop looking up and out, what does that say about us? It's not good. Whatever it is, it's not good. And it's certainly not consistent with how the United States has gotten this far.
So what argument that you've made to lawmakers has been the most, which one breaks through the most? Is it showing them that chart of here's what China is doing and what we're trying to cancel, what we're not going to be doing?
That's pretty good. Yeah, that's pretty good. But also note, well, name me some states. Alabama, that's a good one, a great one.
George, the best, some would say.
Some might. Florida, Texas, Georgia, these are very conservative states. And they have a lot of space activity, a lot of NASA, Louisiana, a lot of NASA activity in each of these states. And so one might expect, indeed, that Congress would push back, and Congress is pushing back. And thank you, House of Representatives and Senate. They both have, both sides have bills that reject all of these proposed cuts. A question, though, for you, the hard-hitting investigative reporter, is what, whose idea was this to cut NASA science in half? What, I mean, it is a sliver. It is barely noticeable piece of the economic pie, the budget pie. It's really a remarkable idea.
Yeah, well, that was kind of the argument that some critics made when they cut USAID, which was, if you really want a cut of the federal government spending, like you'd go to the Pentagon or you'd look at certain things like that. Bottom line, if an lawmaker is listening tonight and is like, or someone at the White House is listening, what would your argument be to them?
My argument would be the U.S. Constitution, now available in paperback, Article 1, Section 8, Clause 8. Congress is to promote the progress of science and useful arts. 1787, the founders put the word science in the U.S. Constitution. It is a remarkable thing. They realize the value for international competitiveness, our health and welfare. Thanks for having me on.
I love that you carry the Constitution in your pocket.
All the kids are doing it.
Bill Nye, always surprising us and always a pleasure to have you. Thank you for joining us tonight.
Thank you.
And keep us updated on your efforts. We'll continue to follow that.